世界で活躍するエマニュエル・パユとマリー・ピエール・ラングラメ。20年以上共演を続けてきた2人にお話を伺いました。
Actually, we could be a good couple, no? At least on stage.
Yeah, well, I don't know. It starts feeling like family after so many years.
Yes, yes. I think we're a musical family, actually.
Yeah. And what's really nice is that as an old couple, we don't need to speak anymore. We understand each other without speaking.
Yeah, after all these years, we breathe together. We look at each other. We know already which way it's going. You know, a bit faster, a bit slower, or just anticipating, or waiting a bit more, or softer. So it's really, really great musical contact. It's really great to make music together.
For me, it's always an incredible joy to play with Emmanuel, really. I don't know, there are so many subtleties, and as I was saying, we don't need to speak about things, and I mean, all these incredible colors, and for me, Emmanuel makes me forget the flute completely, you know, and it's beyond the instrument, and also there is a kindness, I will say, also in the relation, and I feel protected by him, I don't know.
My Pierre is probably the musician I know who transcends her own instrument in the most incredible manner. Where most of the harp players stop, technically or musically, this is Marie-Pierre, where Marie-Pierre is actually starting. And right away you give me the energy and the trust and the confidence to go beyond and go right, dive into the music. And Marie-Pierre is music, basically.
But I had a problem for a long time with Emmanuel. I'm growing out of it. Well, he's, you know, he's like so famous and so talented, and I had a real complex, and I would make myself miserable so many times playing with you. You know it, and he forgave me so many times for so many mistakes, and I mean, I think the best time of my musical relationship with Emmanuel I'm living now, really. I can say. Because I've grown out of these complexes and difficulties. It's like Jean d'Ormesson. Did I tell you that one?
The French philosopher Jean d'Ormesson.
The French philosopher, he just died actually. And he said what's difficult in a marriage are the first 40 years. Sorry, it's really bad. No, but.
Oh, what is difficult in marriage are the first 40 years.
40 years.
Right, yes, so we're nearly there.
After everything gets easy,
フルートとハープのための協奏曲は、数あるモーツァルトの作品の中でも特に美しい旋律を持つ曲として知られています。パユとラングラメはこの曲で何度も共演し、その度に名演を残してきました。
How many times have we played this piece together?
We didn't count, but I mean,Well, the first time we played it, we had practiced it so much, you know, before the first time we... I remember fighting about this very concerto.
Yes, we have been having some musical arguments about Mozart.
Yeah.
This is crazy. Now we agree about Mozart. I think the secret in music is when people get together and have different ideas, we should give it a respectful try to the first, at first, to the several options. But we played it a lot, and now...It's there, and there's a sparkle, and we're ready to change, to refresh it.
Right.
And I think it's the secret of Mozart, that it's forever a young music, actually.
Yeah. And you can improvise your dynamics a little bit, and I don't know. It does feel very spontaneous.
Yeah, there's a great range of human expression, actually, in this music. Mm. The whole range. Mm. Quite private, actually. And this music where you get...
Goosebumps
and really fully loaded with emotion and happiness, or sometimes tears of happiness, just by listening or playing this music. So this incredible, endless love, I think, is something quite strong, powerful, but as you say, also very intimate and deeply intimate and secret and private in the same moment.
それではデニス・ラッセル・デイビスの指揮でモーツァルト作曲フルートとハープのための協奏曲をお聴きください。
Thank you.
Thank you.